I'm Lieutenant Kent Robertson with the South Salt Lake City Fire Department, and we're working today with the Utah Jazz and the Jazz Bear on a fire prevention video on how to keep you safe in fires. Oh, here he comes now. Hi, Bear. Hey, Bear. We're here to talk a little bit about our fire engine here, and we're going to show you some of the things that we do to keep us safe in fires. First thing we do before we ever get into a vehicle and start it, we get into the vehicle and we put our seat belts on. It's very important to make sure that we're all wearing our seat belts. That way, when we get in an accident, we're safe and we stay safe from injury and hitting the windshield or hitting the dash. We're going to take a look at the rest of the equipment on our truck and we'll step out to the back. Right here is where the firefighters ride, and the first thing you see inside the cab is an air pack and a mask. The thing you need to remember about in a fire is it's very hot and there's no air. So if you're involved in a fire at any time and there's smoke in your room, you always need to be low on the floor, crawling where the good fresh clean air is. Bear's got a helmet here. Very important we wear helmets, because a lot of times in fires, things fall on our head. We want to keep safe from that. We've also got some safety glasses that Bear's got. And a radio so we can talk to each other. And of course, our fire boots. Bear here, he's got all kinds of stuff. We use this as another part of our radio so we can talk to each other. And most people who know, have seen a fire, know that it's very black. So we also have large flashlights to peek, because we can't see in a fire. So we make sure that we take those in with us. Okay, once again, here's our air pack. It's pretty heavy. So we step out to the side of the truck. We carry all kinds of equipment. When we get further back, we'll show you our ladders and a few other things. Carry rope for rescuing people out of high buildings. Carry chainsaws in case we have to cut the roof open to get the smoke out. In the back here, we carry all of our hand tools. Axes, pry bars, shovels, things like that. Many people know about the jaws of life. We also carry those on our truck. If you're in a car accident and trapped in a car, we have to use these to cut the car apart to get you out. And these are the cutters and spreaders. We have large fans that we use to blow air into a fire, because it's very hot in a fire and we want to cool that down and get that smoke out of the house. If you look on the back where Bear's at, there's a lot of hose up there. We have big hose for water from a fire hydrant, and we have smaller hose for actually fighting the fire. Of course, we have our nozzles too that we use to squirt water. They're much like your garden nozzles. Most of these are very large lines for a very large fire. We have smaller lines up front. Okay, on this side of the fire engine, we have lighting. And we also have a generator, because in fires, it's very dark. So we have to carry our own power and our own lighting systems. Okay, in the next compartment, we have air packs. So we can keep ourselves with fresh air in a fire. We also have our airbags. And Bear here, he's even got an air mask. These airbags are used to lift vehicles or equipment or concrete or whatever happens to we need to be lifting. They're very strong. We can even lift the fire engine off of the ground. Okay, in our next compartment, we have all of our tools and equipment for the engineer. The engineer's job is to make sure that the water gets to the firefighters, and he has to make sure that he runs the pump and knows all his pressures. We have, once again, the big hoses for fire hydrants and the smaller hoses, and we have our nozzles. These are the nozzles we use to fight fires with. It's very similar to your garden nozzle. Okay, and this is the pump. This is where all the work is done on the fire engine. Anytime we have a fire, each one of these gauges shows a different pressure of water that's coming out of the pump to fight the fire with. Fire engines carry about 500 gallons worth of water in them, and that's why we have fire hydrants, is to make sure that we have enough water to be able to fight the fire. Hold on, jump up in the engineer's seat and we'll talk a little bit about where the driver is. This is where the driver sits. His job is to get us to the fire. If you look up above Bear, all the lights and everything are up above there. And That's where he operates. His main job is to get us to the fire safely and to run the pump once we get there. Okay, Bear, let's jump out and we'll take a walk through our fire station. Bear, I see you found our exercise room. Oh, Bear, you know you shouldn't work out alone. We always make sure we have a partner in here to keep us safe when we're exercising. Each shift we come in, we work out 1 hour a day to keep ourselves physically fit and meet the demands of the job. Come on across the hall and we'll show you where we eat. We'll step into our day room and we'll talk a little bit about it. Firefighters work 24-hour shifts, so we have to have a place where we can relax and cook and eat. We also sleep at the fire station. We have bedrooms in the back where we sleep. We've got 3 refrigerators so that we've got food for each one of the shifts. We have 3 shifts. Firefighters work 24-hour shifts. And we do our own cooking and cleaning. Gotta watch that, Bear. We're gonna go ahead and head back over to our training room and we'll talk a little bit about Operation Edith and the importance of that. Okay, Bear, this is our training room. We're gonna talk a little bit about Operation Edith. Exit drills in the home. Everyone who has a home or an apartment needs to realize it's very important to practice exit drills. 2 ways out of every room. Remember, Bear, when we were in your room, how we had the door shut and the smoke came underneath of it? We checked that door for heat and we crawled low in smoke. We went out the second exit. Always make sure there's 2 exits out of each room. Once we get outside, we need to go to a meeting place to make sure everybody's out. Then go to a neighbor's house to call 911. Also, we need to make sure that we know what to do if our clothes catch on fire. Stop, drop, and roll. Once you call 911, you'll talk to a lady who's a dispatcher or a gentleman, and they'll ask you some specific questions: your address, your name, the phone number you're calling from, and also what is occurring. Not only can you get the fire department from 911, but you can get paramedics, the ambulance, and also the police department. Very important, that number is 911. What number's that? Thanks, kids. Okay, we want to hit the topics, one more that we covered. First off, we need to make sure that when we have our smoke detectors, we check our batteries, and we check them once a month. We change those batteries when we change our clocks. We need to have smoke detectors in our bedrooms and in the hallway. Next thing we need to make sure we do is sleep with our bedroom doors closed to keep the smoke out. If we hear our smoke detector go off at night, we need to get down on the floor where there's fresh air, crawl to the door, check it for heat. If it's not hot, go out. If it is hot, we need to go out the second exit, go out your window, just like the bear did. Okay, once we get out of the house, we need to go to our meeting area. Always have to have a meeting area to make sure everyone is out of the house. We go to the neighbor's house to call 911. From 911, we can get the fire department, the police department, and also paramedics. Okay? That's about it for today, kids. And we want to keep you safe and get him, guys!